Hello everyone, welcome to LICD lecture 21A. Today we are going to discuss the design of a stable multivibrator or square wave generator using op-amp. So let us start. So this is my design statement. We have to design a square wave generator for a frequency of oscillations f0 equal to 1 kHz. We have further assumed that the op-amp is powered with plus or minus 11 volts DC supply. So here is my circuit diagram for my a stable multivibrator. So we have a resistor R1 and R2 going as a positive feedback, and R3 and C1 will be controlling the frequency of oscillations. Okay, so for a time period of design of a stable multivibrator means that we need to find the unknown values of R1, R2, R3 and the capacitor C1. So that is what you mean by design. For this requirement, for the frequency of oscillations as 1 kHz. So let us begin with the design. So the time period for a stable multivibrator or square wave generator is given by T is equal to 2 times R3 into C1. Actually, this is C1. Yeah. So please treat it as C1. So 2 times R3 into C1, natural log of 1 plus beta upon 1 minus beta. So basically, your beta is R2 upon R1 plus R2. So please remember that. So when we assume the value of R1 and R2 as, let's say, 10 kilo ohm, since it is a resistor, we have to write its wattage rating. So we are selecting a quarter watts resistor, and the beta will become as 10K divided by 10 plus 10K, that will be half. So in this formula, we'll go back and substitute the values of beta, that is 0.5. So it will be T is equal to the time period of time period for a stable multivibrator of the output waveform will be T is equal to twice R3 into C1, natural log of 1 plus 0.5 divided by 1 minus 0.5. That will be natural log of 3. So if you work out in a calculator, the T will be equal to 2.1972 R3 into C1. So we are given the value of F0 as 1 kHz. So F0 will be 1 by T. So here we substitute the value of F0, and there are two unknowns, that is R3 and C1. So R3 into C1 is coming out to be 0.455 into 10 raised to minus 3. So we assume the value of C1, it's easier to do that. So C1 is 0.1 microfarad. So you recalculate, algebraically calculate the value of R3, which will come out to be 4.55 kilo ohms. So as a standard design, you select it as, for standard value of resistor, R3 will be 4.7 kilo ohms, quarter watts. Basically, when we do this experiment in the lab, we have a breadboard and a resistor. So standard value of resistors will be, you need to select 4.7. 4.55 is not available standard, but when we do this design in LTSpice, we can select the same value, 4.55. Because in LTSpice, simulations, we can substitute the same value. So hence the design circuit will be this. My value of R1 and R2 are same as 10 kilo ohm. C1 is 0.1 microfarad, and 4.55 kilo ohms is the value of R3. So in this circuit, the output will oscillate between plus or minus Vsat. So our VCC and VE are given as around 11 volts. So VCC plus or minus Vsat will be 90% of VCC, which will be close to 10 and minus 10. Plus Vsat will be plus 10 and minus Vsat should be minus 10. So we have come to a reflection spot. That means we have to move away from this one known PDF and go to LTSpice. So let's build a square wave generator using op-amp. So all the design values are over here. So we will observe the plot of voltage across the capacitor and the output voltage. Basically here in this circuit, if you notice carefully, there is no input. Basically, it's generating a square wave. So that's why it's called as a square wave generator. So let's observe this in LTSpice. Okay, so let me just minimize this. Okay, so we have already built up the circuit in LTSpice. So this is my circuit for a stable multivibrator. As you can see, C1 is 0.1 microfarad. Your value of R3 is 4.55 we have took, and the value of R1 and R2 are 10 kilo ohm each, and the op-amp is powered by plus or minus 11 volt supply. So let's observe the output first of this. So if I run it, let me close this let me try the running again. So here is my first circuit. So here it is, my voltage across the capacitor and my output voltage. So let's check these values in the table. So let me expand this a little. Yeah, so also let me reduce the number of cycles. I mean, it's okay, fine, let it be, not a problem. So these are my input, the capacitor voltage waveforms and the output voltage. So from here we can determine VTL and other stuff. So let us find that. Okay, so here we can find VTL and VTH as beta times VSAT, and beta is around, you know, half, and VSAT is around, 10. So VTH and VTL should be around plus or minus 5. That's the theoretical value. Okay, a calculated value, theoretically calculated value. Let's calculate it in simulation. So your positive value of VSAT is around 10, and negative value is also minus 9.99. So it's coming quite close, plus or minus VSAT. Now let's check the value of VTH and VTL. So VTH and VTL will be over here. This is my VTH value. So let me bring the cursor over here. Yeah, it's around 5.15, close to that number. So we are getting around, it should be 5. We are getting 5.15. That's reasonably a good value. Now, let me just put it back and check over here. So this value over here is my VTL. And this value is coming out to be, let us check from the cursor. It's coming out to be minus 5.1466. So minus 5.147. Okay, so these are the values which we are getting. And now it's also important to verify the time period. So our desired time period is 1 millisecond and it is calculated. So here we expand this cycle, and at zero we can measure from year to year. So let us start doing that. So here it is my value at zero. Okay, around nearby zero. And one more cursor I will take. And this I will paste it over here. I mean, it's really difficult to get the value exactly at zero. Okay, so not a problem. We can. Okay, I guess. Let us check it again. Yeah. So it's around 1.7 minus 0.7 milliseconds, so close to 1 millisecond basically. So you will get exact number as point. I mean, it is not exactly, you know, at the proper point. It's not going to zero, so not a problem. What we can do is we can subtract the value like this. So yeah, as I move my cursor over here, I'm getting a value of x and y coordinates. So I'm getting 1.738 millisecond. You can check it out in the lower corner, x, y coordinate. And over here, if I check it, I will get close to 0.755 millisecond. So if I subtract the two, I'll get close to 0.98 millisecond. So that is quite close to one. So if you reverse it, I will get F0 designed as 1 kilohertz, and over here we are getting 1.02 kilohertz. So that's reasonably fine. Okay, now let us again go back to the PDF. Okay, so this is how we can check the the design, the values, whether they are coming correctly or not. Okay, now let us see one more concept. So one more concept is, let's say we want to, you know, in the previous circuit we had no control over the output. The output was actually automatically going to plus 10 and minus 10 because VCC being, 11 volts and minus 11. So the output was going to plus VSAT, minus VSAT automatically. It was no control. But what if we want to control the output voltage, peak to peak voltage? So a slight modification in the same design is required. So over here, what we will do is, here we can consider it to be 4.55 kilohms. Don't worry. It's 4.7 also is a standard value. So what we do over here is, we do this. let me just reduce it. Yeah. So we connect this voltage limiter, that is two zener diodes back to back like this, one after the other. So D1 and D2 are the two zener diodes. So back to back zener diodes, D1 and D2 act as a voltage limiter. So if the zener voltage is breakdown voltage is around 6.8 volts, so the output will oscillate between. Let me just reduce this font a little more. Yeah. So if my zener breakdown voltage is 6.8, here the output will oscillate between the positive number will be VD1 plus VZ2, and on the negative side we have VD2 plus VZ1. Okay. So here VZ1 and VZ2 are 6.8 breakdown voltage, and my VD1 and VD2, the zener diode normally act as a normal diode, silicon diode, in forward bias. So its on state voltage will be around nearby 0.7. So here, if you add them together, the output will should oscillate between our user defined value. That is, we wanted to oscillate between 7.5 to -7.5, and not go to VSAT as seen previously. So what we will do is we will check this now. So we will make the similar circuit and check it out whether we are getting around 7.5 and all or not. Okay, so let us do that. So before going there, we have one more circuit over here. Yeah, if you see carefully, so your earlier circuit we have used OP07, and you know, this side left hand side which uses a faster op amp. So let us test its output. So let me open another plane plot, and here I'll plot the faster op amp output. As you can see, the difference over here. So the faster op amp will have less less time from switching over from plus VSAT to minus VSAT. And you can see the curves are also very, very sharp. The voltage waveform, and here it is a little dull. So that's the difference of using a faster op amp. And so we should try to use an op amp with a higher slew rate. Now let me close this and open up the limiter circuit. A stable multivibrator with limiter. So a stable multivibrator with limiter will have this two zener diodes back to back. And if I right click on any zener, it will give the breakdown voltage as 6.8. So it is as expected. Rest all the things are same. We have just added a zener diode so that we can control the output amplitude peak to peak. So according to us, and according to the theoretical calculations, the Vout should be between 7.5 and -7.5. Let us check out. So these are my capacitor waveforms and this is my output waveform. Okay, so first of all, let us check how much is my Vout. So Vout is coming out to be 7.47. Is that as per predictions? Okay, let us go over here. Yes, because now the plus or minus VSAT is actually 7.5 and -7.5. So your VTH and VTL value should be beta times, and let me expand it. VTH will be beta times VSAT. VSAT is 7.5 over here, and minus VSAT is -7.5, and beta is around half, as you can see. So automatically your VTL and VTH will become 3.75 and -3.75. Now let us check whether we are getting plus VSAT as 7.5 close to. We are getting 7.47, and negative VSAT is around. Okay, let me just. Negative is also -7.47. So that's quite close. Now let's check the VTH and VTL value. So this is my VTH value. So it's coming close to 3. Let me just. Okay, 3.74. Correct. And we should get around, I mean, we are getting at almost perfectly. I don't know how this 3.8 has come up, but it's okay. I mean, we are getting much better, so we should be more happy. So I think I might have selected a different transistor. That's why. Maybe a slower transistor. So that's why it was coming like this. No problem. With a faster op amp, we are getting much more accurate values. So here my VTH is 3.74 and the expected value should be 3.75. And let's check the value of VTL. So VTL value will be also, let me just use a cursor and again check it. Okay, so -3.73 and expected answer is -3.75. So perfectly fine. Yeah, I suspected correctly. The op-amp used over here is LTC6244. If I use a normal op-amp, I'll get those values. So let's do that. So let me go to the library and select OP07 so that the numbers will match as per given in 120 dBm. Okay, so this is my slower op-amp now. Again, simulate the circuit. I will get some changes. Yeah, I have got those changes. Yeah, definitely. So this is the values which we are getting with the slower op-amp. So you're around 3.83. So you remember I have written here 3.833. This was for OP07. And similarly for VTL, you will get, let us check. So for VTL also, you will get close to minus 3.83. So yeah, these values are perfectly matching. And now let's check the time period. So time period will be between two cycles. So what we will do is we will check the time period over here. Okay, so I will take one cursor and place it over here exactly at zero, close to zero, and take another cursor and take it over here exactly close to zero. So you see the subtraction between the board is coming out to be 767 microseconds. So it's converted to 0.97967 milliseconds. So it's quite close to what we are getting. Around we got around 0.978 millisecond. That's fine, perfectly fine. And when you do inverse, that is frequency, it will be close to 1.022 kilohertz. So that's how we check the values when we make a voltage limiter circuit for a stable multivibrator. Basically we are, with this circuit is generating a square wave, and this voltage limiter will decide what value will be the amplitude of the square wave, peak to peak value. So we have completed our design, both the designs. So that's it for this lecture. Next time we'll study the a stable multivibrator in more details. So until then, have a good day and thank you.